Lavender County, joined this morning with Colleen Begovich, Susan Peters. Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning, girls.
Yeah. I can't believe it's already the third annual Jackson Midtown Run.
I know.
That's unbelievable.
And we're doing good.
And very successful, I must say.
Yes. Very successful. Almost 42,000 in 2 years.
Wow, that's great. That's great.
All going to the food bank, the Interfaith Food Bank.
That's wonderful. And what a great thing to do. I mean, we say this all the time here, and Cam and I, and I know everybody here, we always give. I mean, it's just so important to help people.
When you realize that in 2011, when the food comes into the food bank, it's all weighed. Last year, they distributed 1,529,958 pounds of food. It's a lot.
That is.
Yes.
They utilize the food bank 53,000 times. That's how many walk-ins they had.
Holy crap.
Normally, 50 to 60 on a day. A couple weeks ago, 100 people came through those stores.
Yeah.
I mean, the need is here.
Sure. Absolutely.
We have to take care of our own.
Right. You better believe it, and we do it well.
And I think this is a great concept, because part of getting out and walking and running is a healthy thing. So it's good for you yourself as the participant, but also you're getting involved in helping raising money for the hungry, which is, you know, just a double benefit.
Well, and the third thing that it does is that we have those grab bags that all the participants get, and we encourage local businesses to put in coupons. And because if our businesses are doing well, then they'll hire more people get jobs, they don't have to have assistance.
Right.
So it's good for the businesses to get involved as well, and it gives them an opportunity to get people come through their doors as well.
Okay. So, do you have to be a sponsor of the event to put something into the goodie bag, or how does that work?
Well, we'd like them to be a sponsor, but just by putting stuff in the goodie bag. For example, Emerald Nuts, they gave us boxes of little grab bags of nuts last year, and they're doing that again this year. So we consider that a donation, and it's a sponsorship.
Right.
And so we put them in the grab bag, and they get a name on the
melon face
on the shirt.
Always. Put in, they actually monetarily sponsor us, but then they also put in a coupon. So from morning till about 2 o'clock, you can bring this coupon in and get 15% off your meal.
Right. So a good way as a business to kind of get their name out.
Absolutely.
To how many people do you usually have run the race?
First year was about 100, maybe right about 100, and last year we were what?
At 190 last year.
Wow.
Good.
Yeah.
We really ramped up.
Adding
the 10K run part, there weren't a ton of people in the 10K, but it really did add another element to it, and you did get some more people with that.
The energy that it creates makes people go, I'm helped this year. I want to go. I want to tell my friends, and it's good. It's a good feeling.
And do you attract runners from out of the area? Runners and racers kind of they travel to different areas, and when they hear about a race, they bring their friends and they all kind of show up.
Exactly.
So you're actually bringing people to the county.
Exactly. Mm-hmm.
And we'd like to market that more if we can, you know, try to get more people in. And then not only participate in the event in the morning, but then maybe go to Melon Fays or go out to the wineries and taste wine and buy wine and stop in Sutter Creek and in downtown Jackson and shop locally.
And for people like me, it says run, walk. So
yeah.
Walk is a big word.
I think we've already set it up in categories. We've got run over here and we've got walk over here.
We have
butt right here.
We have way more walkers than we have runners. And we
have
lots
great.
Of dogs to boot. So
good.
And
that's
strollers.
Right.
And strollers. And
what a way to get the kid into fitness at a young age.
I think that's
and
cute.
Let me tell you, there are plenty of dads who run with the stroller.
Okay, let's tell the viewers when the registration is and where you sign up.
Okay, the event is on October 7th, which is a Sunday. Registration starts at 7 in the morning. Run starts at 8. We have a kids run at about 7:30 in the morning. Registration is $25 for the 5K. $35 for the 10K, comes with a really cool t-shirt. We have new artwork this year. And as Monday, those registration fees bump up by $5. So get your registrations in. You can drop them off at Bodies in Balance up by Safeway in that shopping center, or you can mail them in, or drop them off at the City of Jackson,
wherever.
And Bodies in Balance just did an expansion up to by Safeway up there.
Yes.
Great.
A lot more room there?
A lot more room. We love that space.
Right. Good.
It's just awesome. It's amazing.
That's great. That's wonderful. And remember, you know, start in when you go shopping, pick up an extra can of here, an extra box.
Yeah, we will be accepting food donations at the event as well.
Good. So can somebody just, if they can't run or walk, can they just stop by and drop off?
By all means, and come check it out. We'll have lots of vendors there, and there's lots of activity, and you'll know a million people up there because, you know,
great. And you're starting
there.
Where?
We are starting this year. Last 2 years we've started at St. Sava. We weren't able to secure that. We're going to run through the St. Sava complex, but or walk. But we're starting on Huberty Way, which is right next to the hospital. Sutter Amateur Hospital is letting us stage there.
Great. So get out there and do that. Cam will be dragging, and I'll be dragging. We'll be dragging each other.
Sunday, October 6th.
7th.
Sorry, 7th. Third annual. Got that part right?
Yeah.
I can't believe it's
Jackson
already
Midtown.
I know. It's great. Yeah, get out there and help everybody and start saving your food and bring it by. Bring it by. Best thing. You can take us to a break, young man.
We're out of here. We'll be back. Stick with us.